What's up, guys? In this video, I'm going to share with you my experience with testosterone replacement therapy. I'm going to go over what my results have been from injecting testosterone for almost a year now. All the things that I learned along the way through trial and error and painstaking research, and all the things that I wish I knew initially. Unfortunately, just like with pickup, there's so much bad information on this topic. People who have no idea what the fuck they're talking about, giving their opinions, which are not actually based on any real experience or scientific fact. That's why in this video, I want to clear up all the testosterone myths and just give you guys the real scoop on this topic. Answer all the questions that I personally had myself a year ago. This is going to be the video that I wish someone showed me initially. Now, I know this is not directly related to Tinder or text game or profile pictures, but if you're serious about maximizing your success with women, you have to maximize your health as well. This is because women are just biologically wired to be attracted to strong, healthy, fertile men. If they couldn't tell the difference between that and a weakling with a limp dick, then as a species, we would have never made it. So where does testosterone fit into all of this? Unfortunately, one of the big issues facing men in the 21st century is, on average, lower levels of testosterone. Men now have less testosterone on average than they did 50 years ago. This is just due to, all the stresses that come with living in the 21st century. All the shit in the food, all the shit in the water, all the shit in the air, all the chemicals, all the cell phones. Unfortunately, our bodies were just not designed to thrive in the environment that we live in. However, fortunately, we also have certain tools at our disposal that they didn't have 50 years ago. And one of those tools is testosterone replacement therapy. Now, any tool, it's not right for every situation. But for some people, in some cases, it can be very beneficial. So let me quickly touch on how I got started with all of this. I've been getting my blood work done since I was 18, just always tracking my health and being vigilant about it. And my total testosterone was always, it was okay. It was around 600, 650, not great. Probably should be higher for someone, who's 18, 19. But, it's not too terrible. My free testosterone, though, was always on the low side. This was due to a high sex hormone binding globulin, which is an issue a lot of people have. I'm going to touch a little bit more on that later. So due to the high SHBG, my free testosterone was pretty meh. Something that a 40 or 50 year old might have. But it was never too terrible that, I really needed to address it. Then about a year and a half ago, I got hit with Lyme disease. And one of the issues I had with that is that it caused all my hormones to crash. I basically was feeling like shit. I lost a lot of weight. I went from being, like 160 to 135 pounds. I was literally like a walking skeleton. If you want to get an idea of what I look like, just check out the videos from a year ago. And also I had a really bad neck injury that was just, taking a while to heal. So basically I was looking to, go back to where I used to be with my health. Now I probably could have just waited and just slowly bounced as I treat the Lyme, but slowly things would have more or less returned back to baseline. But my baseline was never that great to begin with. So because of that, those two reasons, I decided to give testosterone a shot. So here I am about a year later. I've been testosterone for TRT for about a year now. And I'm not going to say that it made a night and day difference, but it was one of the things that I did that definitely helped me improve my health. I'm about 165 pounds now, pretty good shape, just constantly going to the gym and putting on muscle and, training 6 days a week. So my health is definitely better now than it was a year ago. And one of those reasons is using testosterone. So how do you know if testosterone might be right for you? If you're like an infomercial. Now first, I want to be clear, nothing in this video is intended to be medical advice. In case you didn't know, I'm not a doctor, so this is just opinion. With that out of the way, if I was talking to a family member or a friend, I'd say the first and most important step is to go get your blood work done. When it comes to your health, you really don't want to be playing the guessing game. You just want to be very scientific and objective. So the three tests that you're going to want to do are total testosterone, which is a test people usually do, but the two they forget or free testosterone and sex hormone binding globulin. And it's essentially you check all these three things, because if you have a decent total testosterone, but you have a really high sex hormone binding globulin like I did, which soaks up all your free testosterone, then functionally you're gonna have low testosterone, because free testosterone is what actually determines how you feel and function. Next, let's take a look at how you'd interpret your own results using my blood work as an example. So first, let's take a look at my labs from a little over a year ago. My total testosterone is 709. Now you gotta keep in mind that the lab range they give you, is based on men from the age of 18 to 80. I shit you not. So you definitely wanna be at the very upper end of the spectrum when it comes to total and free testosterone. And my total testosterone is in the upper range, but my free testosterone is definitely on the low side. And this is because my sex hormone binding globulin is through the roof, which is soaking up most of the testosterone my body makes. Now let's take a look at my labs from like a week or two ago. It looks like not much has changed at first glance, but in reality, the amount of free testosterone I have has essentially doubled. And this is because I increased, you know, the total amount of testosterone that I have to work with TRT, and then I lowered my sex hormone binding globulin with the supplement boron. And as a result of that, the amount of free testosterone that my body has to work with is almost twice as high. Hopefully this helps you understand the numbers a bit better. But basically, you want your free testosterone to be in the very upper end of the range. If that's the case, then awesome. If not, then you can consider how you're going to improve it. And one of the tools at your disposal is TRT. It's not the only tool, but it is the most powerful one. However, before you consider going down that route, I do really recommend that you try to maximize what your body can produce naturally. And you do this by focusing on the variables that really matter, which is food, sleep, and exercise. Really just maximizing those three things and also fixing any vitamin or mineral deficiencies that you might have. That's also pretty big. You know, most of the supplements or whatever, the testosterone boosters are largely horse shit. So really just focus on those three things, fixing any deficiencies. Then you can logically evaluate, you know, what your best case scenario baseline and see, you know, if you're happy with that or, you know, it's something you still want to keep tinkering with. Now, if you do decide to give TRT a shot, I do really recommend you do it under the supervision of a doctor. It's just one of those things, you'd rather be safe rather than sorry. So I would just go on Google and look up functional medicine doctors in your city and find someone, you know, who has really good reviews and schedule a consultation. Personally, I would avoid traditional endocrinologists because most of them are just going to be a waste of time, if I'm being frank. So once you find a doctor, you know, come up with a plan, you know, tell him what your goals are, you know, he'll order blood work and then you can kind of take it from there. Next, I want to go over a few things that I discovered that I think can help really maximize all the positive benefits of testosterone and minimize, if not eliminate, any side effects. Like me personally, I don't really have any side effects. I think a big part of that is, you know, because I'm healthy and I have decent genetics when it comes to this, but also just due to following these things. So first is sticking to intramuscular injections. There's a lot of different ways you can administer testosterone. There's creams, there's gels, there's pellets. But what I find is the most effective way, and most doctors will tell you this, is to do intramuscular. So in my opinion, if you're gonna do it, you might as well do it right. Second is dividing and spacing out the injections. So you can inject testosterone once a week, once every 2 weeks. You know, you can even divide your dose by 7, do it daily. There's a lot of different schemes. But what most people find works the best for them is to do 2 or 3 times a week. That doesn't mean doing 3 times the dose. It just means dividing your dose by 3 and spacing it out. So me personally, I do once every 3 days. And I just find this really keeps my levels in check. It keeps them from skyrocketing by day 1 and then, you know, slowly crashing by day 7. It just constantly keeps them in a good place. In case you're wondering, my dose is 180 milligrams a week. So I do like 80 milligrams once every 3 days. Third is utilizing HCG. So again, any good doctor should also recommend this, but basically this keeps your body, you know, still producing testosterone on its own. It keeps your balls from completely shutting down, which is something that you don't want. And fourth is being really weary of estrogen blockers. In my opinion, from everything I researched, is that estrogen blockers are way more harmful than, you know, TRT ever could be. And that's because they should cause all kinds of side effects. If you block too much estrogen, your bones can even become brittle and you can have all these like stress fractures, which you really don't want, because you don't want superhumanly low levels of estrogen. You want your estrogen to be just like, you know, at an optimal level for a man. So what I recommend is that you try, you know, TRT without estrogen for a month or two, then you get your blood work done and you evaluate if you really need an estrogen blocker. And if you do, you only use as much as you need. Really being careful with that, not to overuse them. Like me personally, I don't need an estrogen blocker at all just because my body naturally really doesn't convert that much testosterone to estrogen. And a lot of people like that. But for some of them, you do need an estrogen blocker. But again, it's just, you know, you want to be very careful with how much you use. And those are pretty much my thoughts on testosterone. So I'm not saying everyone should hop on the TRT bandwagon. A lot of people don't need it. And I do really recommend that you maximize what you can do naturally before you even consider it. That's personally what I did. But you know, I also don't think it should be something that should be stigmatized. Like there's this really weird thing with testosterone where dudes are like, oh, where do you get it for testosterone? I get it from my balls. Like, it's just kind of like this weird stigma, you know, like around using it, but it's really just a tool. Like it's a tool at our disposal. that should be evaluated objectively and not based on like an ego or based on, you know, false information. Hopefully you guys found this video valuable. Let me know what you thought in the comments below, and also show me some love by smashing the like button, hitting the subscribe button, clicking the bell for notifications. Let me know if you want me to make more of these kinds of videos talking about, you know, health and other things not related to TechScape. Don't worry, I'll still do plenty of TechScape. Thank you for watching, and until next time.